previous judgments in quite a lot of the local authorities, and that's going back about 5 or 6 years, a lot of authorities got good are outstanding. I obviously wouldn't have remembered that particular time. We did get outstanding in that. But the bar has been risen. It's risen quite a lot since that time, particularly on the particular cases like the ABP case and all that. So I can give you some figures at the moment. My understanding is that something like of the authorities that have been inspected, something like 25% have been deemed inadequate, and something like 70% have got requires improvement. But you can see where we're coming from there. The present situation is Ofsted have been in the local authority for just over a week. They're going to be in here for over 4 weeks. Our local authority officers and myself and the chair of the policy are working extremely hard. It's quite a difficult task, but do look at all areas now because of what has happened in the over the last 4 or 5 years, and that. And I think that is right. You know, it's right that we should look in great depth in those particular areas. I will say that 1 week is not long enough really to make any judgment on that. We are looking at our a front door, particularly the social services and that. What I would say is that I'm very, very pleased to be able to say, and I think the leader did say that about the schools, 92% of our secondary schools here in the world are good or outstanding, and 74% of our primary schools are good or outstanding. That's the highest we've ever had. But we do await the Ofsted inspection in 8 weeks' time.
Primary schools to give to parents. These are currently the resource some risk. These look races are having no base of risk, and they're then look like control crossing to use correctly. They provide safe crossing places for pedestrians or villagers. I was distributed tomorrow in response to the tour members with some details, statistics, and copy of each of the leaflets, and also a link to the Council Transport website.
Sets out a clear priority to improve Wirral's housing This is why our 2020 plan and supporting housing strategy shows an equal acknowledgement of the importance of meeting local housing needs by providing more homes and improving standards to make the best use of the existing stock. Collectively though, these two key strands, local people in our communities will benefit, and the council can achieve increased resources, not only through the new homes bonus, but also through increased council tax income. The period between 2014 and 15, while showing an increase in empties, needed to be put into the context of longer term trends. Wirral has seen a decrease since 2007 of 35% in long term vacant properties. And all vacants have reduced in the same period by 21.4%. The council has already put in place measures to deter people from leaving their properties empty, such as removing the discount which was available for the first 6 months a property was empty, and applying a 50% premium on council tax for those properties left vacant for over 2 years. It must be acknowledged, however, there will always be an element of long-term empty homes in the market due to a number of issues such as probate. I would finally like to highlight the number of long-term vacants in the social sector, which has decreased by 7% in 2014-15. Therefore, the biggest challenge continues to be, and has been the case historically, in the private sector, which has been recognised and a clear direction set by this administration that officers, along with our partners, continue to tackle the issues of empty properties, including those that are long-term. And just in terms of your final piece, Stuart, the barriers and incentives, yeah, absolutely no problem at all with that. And I will certainly go back and look at what you mentioned about the long-term empty homes strategy being brought in as quickly as possible after the September day. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Davies. I'm sure Councillor Kelly, you would agree, I've covered all the items with you. We'll ask him in detail, so please. We have Councillor Davies, very glad of you. Coming back to, as we said, item 7 on the agenda, pages 89 to 90, in accordance with Standard Order 7, Chapter 5, the Council has to consider the recommendations in respect of this motion as referred by the Council to Policy and Performance Transformation and Resources Committee. The motion seeking fairness in purchasing was considered on the 22nd of March 2016. I invite the former Vice Chair of the Policy and Performance Transformation Resources Committee, Councillor Paul Gowdy, to move the committee's recommendation.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second. Is that agreed? Cabinet.